we get ready to get going. You see the zoo, the beautiful new look here at the Peterson Event Center. We get set for basketball. Hamilton to jump against Melatiche. And controlled by Nicholls State. We look at that Nicholls starting five. And Dexter McClanahan, what a game he had against the Fighting Illini. You may remember D'Angelo Hunter. He's a West Virginia transfer. Block and Panthers get their first possession.
McClanahan started off slow. Picked it up in the second half against Illinois. Let's see if he starts out hot today.
Hamilton in that starting lineup, the transfer, along with Drumgoole and the other three you may remember, the three freshmen, now sophomores for the Panthers, as Hamilton will go to the line.
Speaking of the freshmen, you have Xavier and Trey McGowans. I think this is one of the best backcourts of college basketball. I mean, I know a lot of people might call me crazy, Jeff, but these young fellas can get the job done.
Why is it? What do you like so much about them?
Well, number one, they both can create their own shot and create shots for others. They play with a lot of intensity, which is always a positive in the backcourt. All they really have to do is get more consistent with their jump shooting. And, I mean, talking about guys that's going to have that NBA logo on their uniform soon.
So the graduate transfer senior, Hamilton, with the first point in this game. And misses the second free throw. And a rebound to Nicholls State. Hamilton, and he's got a streak going. Everywhere he's played, they've gone to the postseason. Drive and shot missed.
Carries on.
Here comes Johnson the other way. Drumgoole. He can hit that. Bit of a swing forward guard. Gowans now dribbling.
Tradition going. Young guy in the starting lineup.
Good aggressive defense from Nicholls State. And a first basket for the Colonels. You see McClanahan, not just a jump shooter, guy who can get it done on the defensive end.
Well, yeah, they played a tough, you know, opponent from a big conference in their first game, so they're not going to come in here and back down at all.
And Xavier Johnson walked. Turnover for the Panthers. We saw a little talking there from D'Angelo Hunter.
Solid pressure into the double team, try to go behind the back. Coughed it up. That's good defense.
So 2-1 Nicholls early on and possession of the basketball. Crossover, jump shot, no good, rebound, and a foul on Hunter. Jeff Capel in his second year with the Panthers. Saw he spent time at Duke, took Oklahoma and VCU to the NCAA tournament.
I love the guy. I mean, his basketball IQ is up there. He's been around the game, around a great program in Duke. And he's already made a lot of changes, even not just with the players, but just the vibe that he has with knowing that how he's going to build this program. Can't say enough about it.
Second straight turnover for the Panthers. And, Julius, we were discussing before we got on air, as a player, you weren't a big fan of these noon, especially new non-conference games.
Not at all. You know, the thing is, it throws your rhythm off. You don't really get a good shoot around in because the game is so early, so you kind of hop out of bed, get the meal, kind of get to the gym. So I never was a big fan. Just always started slow.
Foul on McGowans and Austin Clunch. He's got a milestone birthday coming up a week from Sunday. He's going to turn 30.
I think it's cool. I mean, you know, to go outside the box, you know, normally I think programs will look at your age and see that as a minus, but, you know, I'm sure he can relate to these young guys, and as you can see, he got them playing, you know, with a lot of energy, attacking the basket. Why be afraid?
Alatiche with the slam, and it is a three-point lead early for Nicholls State, and another trap, but Johnson able to get out of that. The backdoor cut. McGowans goes in, and a foul on Nicholls. Nice play here, Julius.
Yeah, I mean, that was a great pass in between two players. You almost got to give more credit to the guard for being able to get that pass through there. Got to get that rotation there on time. Good play.
Harvey picked up the foul, and he'll sit. As we see Raji Lyons for the first time. Inbound to Tony.
I want to see him be a little more aggressive. He got off to a slow start last game against Florida State. I think it kind of lingered.
What? Drumgoole open from three. No good. Rebound and a foul on the floor on the Colonels. And a push in the back by Lions.
It's going to be a battle.
Tell you what, I love that pressure they have, the trapping pressure they have up top. The Colonels do. They get you into it.
Absolutely. I mean, you have to go out there and apply pressure, especially when your front court isn't that big and athletic. Got to force some turnovers, get some easy baskets.
Kevin Johnson against Xavier. Panthers have turned over three times now. And we're not even at the first TV timeout. Murphy and Champagne check in, the first substitutions for the Panthers.
Coach Capel talked about being worried about this game a little bit, being that they came off a conference win. You know, team is feeling really good about themselves in today's life that we live in.
Oh, yeah, you don't even have to walk on campus to have people tell you. You just open up your social media and people
Absolutely.
Are just like, you're the best, you're the greatest, NCAA bound. You know, I saw a lot of that stuff online the last few days. And not that that may not be true, but I know coaches say it's as much about how you handle success as you do adversity.
Absolutely.
That one is a turnover by the Colonels. It will be Panthers basketball trailing 4-1 here. So see the drive by McClanahan and ball.
A little nudge with the off arm.
Johnson's going to drive the lane. Throws it up. No good. Rebound. Good work by Hamilton. Hamilton, every fake conceivable, but he traveled.
Tried to get his balance to go up strong there. Good thought.
Good block by Lions.
Well, you know Xavier's going to go in there more times than not. Got to be ready for him. Got to have your rotation ready to rotate against him and McGowan's in particular.
Flanagan guarded by Terrell Brown. Good look down low to Lions, and Lions finishes.
It's a good move. Way to adjust his body. Half control going up there as a big fella. Okay.
Nicholls came to play. Johnson beats three guys, has it tipped out of bounds. Will be Pitt basketball with 13 to shoot.
Yes, I mean, it's a little difficult for Pitt. Nicholls State, you know, who is Nicholls State? It's easy to get caught up in the name on a jersey.
East Tony misses the three. Rebound to Kevin Johnson. McClanahan from three. No good. And good rebound there from Tony.
This is the action that you want to see right here, Brown and Xavier.
And another steal from McClanahan. Again, Brown comes out on him. Three from Johnson. Good. 9-1 Nicholls. Kevin Johnson, the junior out of Thibodaux, Louisiana, which is where the school is. So Kevin Johnson with the three and Nicholls State with an early 9-1 lead over the Panthers.
It's about building something. The thing you want to have is a really strong foundation. I took some of the words and some of the lessons that my dad taught my brother and myself, and this is kind of the foundation that I want our program to be built off of. But everyone that's a part of our program, this is your commitment of being here. This is your pledge that you're part of this, that you're part of these words, you're part of this building process of what we're doing to get this thing back into a national contender and a championship program.
As we're back to live action, Xavier Johnson misses. Good offensive rebounds. Murphy's opportunity is short, but a foul against Murphy. And what do you think of that concept of the brick by brick and having those bricks in the room?
One of the things he didn't mention in that video is that he had Dewan Blair, one of the former players, come in and sign the brick. You know, the thing is, I think he did a great job with bringing some of the former players back and having them around in the part of the program, guys that has success. And sometimes, you know, we mentor some of these kids and get them, you know, to play a little harder or things that they can work on. So I think, you know, the relationship the coach is building with us, the fans, the alumni, things of that nature, I think he's spot on.
No one was probably as much a brick as Dewan Blair.
Absolutely. That guy, I still remember the day he flipped over the big fella from UConn. What was his name, to beat?
Yep.
Never can forget that. That's one of those highlights you always remember, where you were when that happened.
I think of a few moments I remember where I was when you were playing, Julius.
No.
The Panthers still waiting for their first field goal in this game. Just free throws so far. Nicholls, the deep three, no good. Chance for an offensive rebound, but Xavier Johnson picks it up, and a blocking foul on Kevin Johnson.
Defensively, it looked like the Panthers were in a little zone. Darren Nicholls State to shoot some jump shots.
Hey, got to mix it up a little bit. Austin Clonch said he liked the intensity that they showed in that second half against Illinois. Well, they've continued it here in the first half so far against Pitt, as Justin Champagne, the first field goal as the confetti flies. The students are holding on to that for a while.
I really like his game. He's a guy who can stretch the floor. He has nice size. He's going to be a really good player here for the Pitt Panthers.
Champagne, just a freshman from Brooklyn. And a three for Nicholls. Xavier Johnson to the corner. Drumbull thought about it. Tried to get it back out and stolen by Kevin Johnson. And an offensive foul on Kevin Johnson. And that's two on the Colonel's point guard. Told you about Nicholls State. And look at that, Julius. It's just points. Forget the other numbers.
Well, if they were turning Illinois over the way they turned the Panthers over early, I can see why. You know, you have the two different tails of these halves. The pressure. Yeah, I mean, and once again.
There you go. Buford to steal, but then a steal right back by McGowan's. He's going to take it to the hole. A wild shot that goes in.
Hit the top of the backboard.
But I believe it hit the top of the backboard.
Trey McGowan's.
As the officials are going to talk about this. Let's see.
Euro step. Get creative. Show the ball. Finish strong. They say when you play with skill, good luck it happen, Jeff.
And the basket counts.
Top of the backboard countdown. Okay. Let's see if he gets the Panthers going.
Austin Clonch not buying it. It's Panthers now within four. McGowan's with 3 points. Champagne with a couple. Murphy with a couple. And now the Panthers a little pressure. Buford was, out of control a bit there was Jones. And a turnover for the Colonels. Let's look at this play again, Julius.
Yeah, you know, the Euro step, popular by Ginobili. Body control, show the ball.
The ball just rains down. You just don't see that bounce. Xavier Johnson looking.
I love these guys.
For Brown, the floater no good. Johnson fights for the rebound, and the ball controlled by the Colonels. And a near foul, ball knocked out of bounds, and it will be Pitt basketball.
Picking up the intensity defensively.
It's off of Buford's hands. And they allowed some contact. It looked like old Big East days.
Oh, not quite. Come on now.
All right, no one was hurt.
Come on, Jeff. See, no. No one was hurt. We was out there trying to play football. It was physical.
Murphy, the fake. Good look. Brown takes it strong to the hole. And now the Panthers within two.
Started last game with Brown. Got in there, got the job done defensively and offensively.
3 from Nicholls State. Andre Jones. And Jeff Capel wants a timeout. Nicholls State, this Nicholls team, they're not afraid. They're not going away.
They already played a top, not a top opponent, but a team from a major conference. So they're not going to be afraid of that. And right here, you're going to play zone. You're going to have some energy, or you're going to give up some open shots like that. So, you know, Nicholls, why should they be afraid? They already are underdogs. They have a 29-year-old head coach. That should tell. I mean, come on. When you're on a role playing against an ACC opponent, you might have been a guy who felt like you should have been recruited at a higher level. They have a lot of reasons to want to come out here and play with a chip on your shoulder.
You see the numbers very good for the Colonels early on. Wide open 3. Murphy, no good. Brown tried for the tip, but good box out from Lyons. And here come the Colonels. McClanahan, and he's wearing that face mask to start here. We'll tell you a story about that as we continue. The drive, good, strong drive from Jones, Andre Jones. Redshirt junior out of Little Rock. So this was kind of the end of the game lineup the Panthers had the other day. You see Brown. Brown's got height. He's working, turning, no good. Murphy tips and controlled by Nicholls and McClanahan.
Well, the Panthers are going to have to figure it out. Because when they go man-to-man, they're allowing penetration and guys to get to the basket. They go zone, they give up the open shot. Something is going to have to give.
McGowan's penetrates, but it's blocked out of bounds. A 7-point lead for Nicholls State, and Drumgoole is in for Brown. And you see that lineup that we just saw out there, they were doing some damage against Florida State.
Well, Brown is a guy, I think it started with him. He's a guy who played a lot of minutes last year. He can block shots. He's already top 15 in Pitt history. Offensively, I think he's probably got an and-one dunk last game, which got the fans into it. So, you know, anytime you can get those easy baskets and you have a guy controlling the paint that way, you can go on a run. We need it this afternoon.
Murphy hits the 2, and on the other end, Xavier Johnson picks up the foul, guarding Andre Jones. That's just number 1 on Johnson. Shooting foul, and the first free throws here for Nicholls State.
You expect this from a young team. You know, McGowan's, Johnson, they're still only sophomores. Playing D right here. Oh, they call it the snake bite right there. Oh, you're not getting away with that anymore. Back in the day, maybe. Wait,
the snake bite?
The snake bite. Tap him on the elbow. Guy's got to move the ball.
Shot clock down. Great move by Hamilton in the lefty finish.
And I think that's where the advantage is for the Panthers. It's going inside. I think they have the more athletic and the bigger guys. Just feed it in there. Let those guys go to work. I understand that your team last year was built around the perimeter play with McGowan's and Xavier Johnson, but right now you have the advantage inside.
Drive and score on the other end. Alatiche. Got a nice body, good control, and a blocking foul against Andre Jones. Nicholls State up 7 here in the first half. We're now midway through.
Out on the perimeter, you see the pressure. I mean, if these guys are smaller, obviously they're going to be able to guard you out on the perimeter, but inside, this is where they're not going to be as good.
Spin move. pretty move. You see Jeff Capel looking over his notes. Audis Tony checks back in for Drumgoole.
What do you think he was looking at on that paper?
What am I going to say to these guys at half?
Don't turn the ball over.
And short. Just little detail mistakes seen from the Panthers. And hey, I don't want to take anything away from the way the Colonels have come out. And they're playing like this is an 8 o'clock primetimer.
Absolutely. I think that, you know, the Panthers, with this being a noon game and the opponent and them being an experienced team still, you know, a team that's more experienced, they understand that it's about the process. It's not about the opponents. So they're ready for this game, knowing that we need to put this team away early just so they don't have the confidence to stick around with us. An experienced team like the Panthers, a young team, they're not quite used to doing that yet.
So an experienced team isn't really looking at the score. They're just thinking about how they're playing, where a younger team might start thinking, man, what are we doing here?
Absolutely.
Johnson kick out to Murphy. Murphy inside the line and good. Ryan Murphy with four.
That's what he's out there for, to stretch the floor. He has two guys that could penetrate. Looking to kick out to him for jump shots.
Three-pointer, no good. Offensive rebound tipped in control by McClanahan. He hurt himself in practice. That's why he's wearing a face shield.
Got a little Hamilton going on.
Good dribbling. A kick out for an open three and buried by D'Angelo Hunter. Boy, he just weaved his way through and found the open man. You're shaking your head.
You
kind of like his game, don't you?
I do. I mean, if you allow a guy to penetrate like that, it's going to collapse the defense. And if guys hitting shots, it's going to be a long game for you.
Good hands
off his leg
by Hunter. Will be Pitt basketball. So Murphy on the move, able to hit that jumper, and then again the other way. Nicholls answers.
Good way to read the screen, continue to penetrate, didn't pick up his dribble, kick it out for the three. Your guy is knocking it down for you.
Bounce for the Panthers, trailing by eight.
Looks like Nicholls is playing somewhat of a matchup zone.
Murphy answers and fires the arrow into the crowd. Murphy now with nine.
I remember when we kicked off the season, they had Wiz Khalifa in attendance. Even during the scrimmage, he was out there letting it fly. I knew he just had that mentality, a guy that was going to let it go.
Oh, and a foul on Johnson. That's two on Xavier Johnson. As Ryan Murphy has led the Panthers, they're now back within five. Murphy with 9 points here in the first half on 3 of 5 shooting. And I know you like that career ambition.
Man, I love it. Usually, you know, these young guys, I understand you play basketball, you're good, you're playing at a high level, your goal is to go to the NBA and play. But you got to look into other things. It's not just basketball. It's great. If you make it, kudos to you, but you gotta have other dreams outside of the sport.
Ball on the floor, loose ball, and no shot clock violation, which was interesting. I would have thought it would have been a shot clock violation with the ball on the ground, but either way, it's Pitt basketball. Jeff Capel trying to get an explanation. Roger Ayers. Sean Hall and Brian Dorsey are the officials for this game. And, you know, when we talked to Jeff about the challenge of, you know, you beat a Florida State and then you come back with a team that a lot of people don't know about, he was dead serious about being concerned, and you can see why.
Absolutely. I mean, you know, Jeff, being the older gentleman, the guy that's been around for a long time, understand the roller coaster ride sometimes players can be on. So when they look at the schedule, they know they have West Virginia coming up. They can overlook this game as, oh, okay, we just got a good win. We can look past the kind of teams that are scrappy. They come in and they can catch you sleeping.
Boy, a sweet block there by Alatiche. The Panthers able to gather control, and Alatiche picks up a foul as Champagne will go to the line.
Justin? I think this guy here is instant offense. He's aggressive.
You like his hair.
I love his hair. I love his hair.
Champagne, 6'6". Yeah, so look at that hair, right?
Right.
And now look at this.
Yeah, that's, so I'm a little biased.
I'm more like Ryan Murphy. Yeah. Yeah, he and I are a little bit more on the same page.
Yeah, he might be losing just a little bit.
It's cool. It's a cool look.
I have good genes when it comes to the hair, so I might be holding on to it for a little while longer.
24-21. Panthers back within three. Nicholls took the lead, and they haven't looked back. There's McClanahan working the screen. Tony, good defense. Drive, stop, pop, no good. And tip by Altatiche. Wow, Altatiche working hard on the glass.
On the glass. Second shots. Got to be able to get that defensive rebound. Pretty good defense by Tony.
What do you think there about how deep the Panthers are setting up their offense? You know, they're up near midcourt trying to set up that offense. They're forced up there. So we take a look. McClanahan's drive, but Altatiche working it.
Keeping the ball alive. If you can't grab the rebound, at least keep it alive. Good tip, something may happen. But that pressure has Pitt out of sync. They're not used to that pressure being picked up right there. Attack it. That's the best way. Forget the play. If you go right by the guy and score, he'll back up off you.
Andre Jones, deep jumper, short, but tipped by Altatiche and controlled by the Colonels. Ball knocked away by Murphy. Murphy has it. There's a break. He's going to stop and pop from three. No good, and a rebound to the Colonels.
Okay. Got to live with that. That's a heat check right there.
Crossover from Jones.
Woo.
Andre Jones. And a drive and a travel. Turnover number 8 for the Panthers.
Transition. Gotta be, yeah. In and out crossover. Wanted to go get show it.
And then he takes it right at Pitt's two big guys.
Yeah. Get up there. Move that ball around a little bit. We saw McGowan's do it here. These guys, man, these guards got to be able to get crafty down there. Use both hands around the rim.
You know, I know that Austin Clonch, as you saw earlier, worked with John Lucas at camps. He also worked with Brad Brownell with Clemson. And you know the intensity that they play with. I mean, you could see that here. And he kind of reminds me of Brownell, like, working the court, too. You know?
He's going to be sweating by the end of the game.
Drive by Altatiche. This one, this time he has his block and taken away by Brandon Moore.
Still the attempt. They're scrappy. You can't be out-scrapped on your home floor.
Deep three. Brandon Moore gets the possession back, buries the three, and Nicholls back up 9.
Well, what do you expect? Pitt has the size. They're on their home floor. If Nicholls is going to compete, they have to come out here and do exactly what they're doing. Force turnovers, get to the lane, get offensive rebounds, second chance shots.
And this time an opportunity for McGowan's. He drives and misses the dunk, but a foul, and McGowan's is down. Thankfully, McGowan's back up to his feet. As you see, Moore rewarding himself with the three. And here comes McGowan's. And a little body contact there from Lyons.
Very little.
You know, we saw Xavier Johnson get the snake bite foul.
Right.
And now a little, just a little foul there. And let me ask you, as a player, did you find that early in the year the officials called a lot more and then it kind of backed off as conference play started?
I think when you're aggressive, the referee tend to give you the benefit of the doubt. So with him going, I think if he would have went to the basket and attempted a finger roll or a layup, he wouldn't have got that call.
Really?
Because he went in there looking to dunk it. usually you get those kind of calls when you're aggressive.
All right, McGowan's goes out, and here's Johnson back in. He's got two fouls. Nicholls State shooting 55% here in the first half. We reach the four-minute mark. Kick out to the corner, blocked by Champagne. Shot clock to 10, and a three by Jalen Forns. D'Angelo Hunter.
That's a tough shot. But they have the lead now. They're not afraid. Any chance that you had to take their confidence early, it's not going to happen.
Biggest lead of the game at 11. Johnson's going to drive. Nifty move, but misses everything. And here comes Nicholls. Hunter and a chance to build on this lead. McClanahan's open from three. No good. But another offensive board. Alatiche misses the putback, and Panthers have the basketball with 3:13 to go in the first half, down 11.
It's a lot of standing around going on. There's penetration, a lot of standing around. It's not much movement outside of the guy that's driving. Although Murphy just made it look a little easy right there. Pitt has to move the ball around and just get some kind of flow. Do the little things that they want to get back into this game one possession at a time.
Murphy has nearly half of the Panthers' points. He's got 11. And a good fake there out in the three and drew the defender.
Well, that's what happened when you hit a couple of jump shots early. They show you the respect.
And, of course, the scouting report would be on him is that he's going to shoot threes. So is McClanahan. He misses, and a foul on the floor on Nicholls State on Jeremiah Buford. It's a 10-point turnover. It really pops, too, with the new colors.
They changed the color. The uniform is just better.
I heard Julius say before the game, he said, man, I grew up in the wrong era. Champagne misses
the around,
first free throw.
So now the Zoo is on the side of the team to make it hard for the opposing teams to come in here and get a W.
Yeah, but you played in places with character.
Yeah,
when
character is a black eye, yeah. You know, sometimes the scars can be, add character to you. Yeah, I get it. That was a good one.
Champagne makes one out of two in the lead cut to eight. It really is gorgeous what they've done here, and they're not done. In some other areas, they're still under construction.
Even the academic support area, they actually redid that as well from the time that I was here. And the resources that you have at this university is just
well, you never needed that. You were always on top of everything.
Yeah,
Hunter,
sure.
Hunter,
I was on top of it when I was doing it.
Murphy, who's played a whale of a first half for the Panthers, drives, and a good tip by Tony. So Aldis Tony, he's got three rebounds now, 2 points. He's looking for something early on to kind of get his game going.
Yes. You know, last game he took a shot, wasn't the best looking shot, and he missed the dunk, unfortunately. Sometimes those things tend to linger. You start doubting yourself a little bit. So it's good to see him contributing, get a little bit of his confidence back.
Jeremiah Buford buries another three, and the lead again back to nine.
Well, it's one possession at a time. And it's going to start on that defense end. You can't come back unless you start stop the other team.
Drive by Johnson lays it up and in. Kareem Koulibaly, by the way, has been in the game here for the Panthers, freshman. And they're coming right at him. The layup no good, and Koulibaly had the rebound. Ball knocked away, ball on the floor, and controlled by Nicholls State. Good head fake. Alatiche kicks out. D'Angelo Hunter, the three. Now 2 of 3 from three. Nicholls State 7 of 14 from beyond the arc.
It's going to have to be on both ends of the floor. Coming out of that timeout, Pitt is getting to the basket like they just did right there with Xavier Johnson. But defensively, they're allowing the team to penetrate. They're allowing Nicholls to penetrate, get offensive rebounds. You can't just trade baskets when you're down.
39-31. Nicholls going to hold for the last possession.
got to be the aggressor.
Andre Jones uses the screen. The pump fake from Hunter and buries the two. And that's how this first half is going to end. Nicholls State, a 10-point lead here at the break, shooting 50% from the floor, 50% from three, and also a plus in rebounding so far in this game. You see the drives from the outside. Jones with 9, Hunter with 10, and Ryan Murphy leads the Panthers with
field goal attempts. The rebounding's about even. Turnovers are about even. And then you look at that three-point shooting.
Well, I think it's the offensive rebounds, though. You know, those offensive rebounds is what's getting more attempts. And typically, when you get more attempts at the basket, you win the game. So that's something that the Panthers are going to have to address if they don't want to upset on their home floor second game of the season.
And Nicholls' big men have done a good job of finishing at the rim as well. Not just getting there, but finishing, as the ball will belong to Nicholls here to start the second half. A 10-point lead for the Colonels. McClanahan right in front of us to inbound. D'Angelo Hunter, the West Virginia transfer.
He's a little familiar with this area then. Comfortable, he might be comfortable. We gotta get him out of his comfort zone to put Panthers.
3-pointer out of bounds was Elvis Harvey. And you think about how different of a half this was. You see the first half at Illinois compared to the second half. They kind of came out, and for the Panthers, they want to see a flip of that here at home.
It's going to start forcing some turnovers right now and containing penetration.
Tony is going to drive, stop, layup, good.
Good move, good finish. Get off the floor, get back in transition, time to play some defense.
4 for the sophomore. Hunter looks down low. Alatiche kicks it out. 3-pointer right there. The hot shooting continues. Kevin Johnson with his second 3. 5 different players for Nicholls have made threes.
Well, it's the penetration, but it's also, you can't die. Once you help, you can't die. As Murphy hits a 3 right here, it's turned into a 3-point shootout.
Murphy answers now with 14. I love the energy that Murphy plays with. You know exactly what he's thinking as Johnson drives on him and finishes over the big man.
Strong move. Get into his body.
Use your body.
Yeah, shield the ball. We're used to seeing McGowan's and Johnson make those kind of plays.
Xavier caught in the air there and bailed out a bit. 15 on the shot clock. Murphy trapped. Good cut inside, but knocked away. Now the drive no good by Elvis Harvey. But he'll go to the line and shoot 2. Just good
slow
fake
closeouts
on Champagne.
All in rhythm. You know, same thing, man. When they're moving, they're helping on defense. They're shooting such a high percentage from the three-point line. At this point, I just want to run them off of it. So if you close out and a guy go by you, I have to live with that right now. I can't allow them to keep getting these open threes.
So you were saying there they were slow to close out.
Yeah, well,
even with
you want
the
to
move.
Close out under control, hands up. You don't want to go for any shot fix, but Nicholls State is shooting the ball so well from three. At this point, I'd rather them do something different. Put it on the floor and rotate.
Good combat rebound there from Tony. Nicholls State up 11. We've seen this lead a few times. And you see Kevin Johnson's kind of got the one eye squinted.
And in that situation, you just got to go right at him. I know you want to run a play and be poised.
And it seems like Nicholls State is just a half second ahead of what the Panthers are trying to do. Credit to them.
Yep, they're being the aggressor.
Alatiche kicks it out.
Here's Johnson. He's still working his eye, and a timeout, and they're going to take a look at it. The official noticed it.
Nicholls State is taking the fight to the Panthers. They're not waiting offensively and defensively. They're attacking the ball. They're picking them up at half court.
And the officials there just checking because they worried if there was lost contact or what was going on with his eye and just wanted to double check. Elvis Harvey gets the inbound and back to Johnson. Lead is 11. Nicholls State.
It's still in rhythm.
And rebound to Tony. What's interesting about this matchup is Nicholls came in, picked 11th in the Southland Conference. Panthers picked 10th. Nicholls, they're the 11th best team in the Southland. That's a really good conference as Terrell Brown finishes at the rim.
He has a mismatch down there. I know it falls outside of the scope of what you would typically do, but I would keep feeding him.
Planahan.
If he hit 30, I would ride him.
Travels.
All the way to a W.
A ninth turnover for the Colonels.
Just look at his size. He's much bigger. Takes his time. Drop step. Mouse in the house right there. That's every single time. That's a mismatch.
How often do you use those lines on your daughter?
All the time.
Do you?
All the time.
Good head fake there from Murphy, but drives into a double team and has the ball taken away. Here comes Johnson.
Got to find his guy. Draw two. Did a good drop draw and two defenders.
Behind the back pass. And a spin move and unable to finish, but Alatiche is there for the rebound off the Harvey miss and a three by Kevin Johnson.
The guy's penetrating, Jeff. It's three guys guarding him. You give up a jump shot and he still gets the offensive rebound. Like, there's no way that you're going to beat anybody in the ACC, let alone Nicholls State.
Ryan Murphy hits the three, and Jeff Capel calls a timeout as Jason Capel yelling at the team, trying to get them going. Nicholls State, solid defense leading to offense for the Colonels. As eventually, Johnson nicked for a Panther run that just really hasn't happened.
Well, it starts defensively. Defensively, they got to stop penetration and stop letting them get offensive rebounds. Offensively, I'd say just keep throwing it to the big fella. He has a mismatch. I know that's not something that we're used to seeing with Trey and Xavier handling the ball and penetrating and things like that, but I think Brown can get it done with the matchup that he has.
Raji Lyons has come in, the big man for the Colonels. Lyons 6'10". Another three, this time a miss. And fighting for the rebound and finally controlled by Terrell Brown. Here comes Murphy. Murphy looking down court. Drives, floater, no good. Rebound tipped around and controlled by Murphy, but throws it away. Here comes Johnson the other way for Nicholls State. Drive, blocked by Brown. So a rebound and now a block by Brown. And that block puts him in the top 10 all time for Pitt history. Good look down low. Drumgoole finishes in the foul.
What's more impressive about Brown reaching that milestone is that he's probably done it in the least amount of games as anybody on that list.
50-43. The Panthers go to the line. They're trailing by seven here in the second half. Down 11 at the break. And still down seven here in the second half.
Find a little pressure, might get the job done. Extending it out.
You know, you said you want the extended defense. You got to worry about getting beat deep, and that's what Andre Jones did right there. Drive right into your lane. And McGowan's tried to do that, lost it. Who else is there but Ryan Murphy?
He's everywhere right now.
Ryan Murphy with 19. His career high is 27. Oh, drive by Jones, but a block by Brown. Ball loose on the floor. Bodies down. A jump ball would go Panther way. I assume that's what we're going to get here. Jones drives. And ball on the ground. It will be a jump ball Panther basketball.
I would like to see Brown get on the floor.
Murphy, 6 of 12 from the floor, 3 of 5 from 3. We're going to show you a little later. He does it by hard work. It's not by accident. Guy works at his craft. He went from Charlotte to a JUCO because he said he wanted to work on his all-around game and not just be known as a shooter. And he's showing some of that today, and he's impressed that way. Jeff Capel was saying, he didn't realize how well-rounded that Murphy's game was. And really, Murphy working some point here. Inbound for Nicholls State.
You don't want to have any weaknesses in your game. If he was a good shooter, players are going to run you off that line. The best thing you can learn how to do is handle the ball. So, kudos to him for understanding that and not wanting to just specialize in one thing. Add more value to his team.
Andre Jones, he's had a big game as well. 11 points. Kevin Johnson with 11. And Hunter with 10. Balanced scoring for the Colonels. 5 on the clock. Wide open 3 from Johnson. No good. Fight on the glass. Controlled by McGowan's. Here come the Panthers. Down 7. And no call as McGowan's leads in and gets the Panthers within 5.
If I just pick up this defense just a little bit, they're showing.
Jones drives, has it knocked away by McGowan's and out of bounds. And Colonels basketball, and Clanahan checks back in. What do you think here?
I think it was a good no call. Didn't really have any contact there, or could just be the Big East bias that I have from playing, running guys over.
If you're not carted off, you're not trying hard enough. I think that's what it said, Big East, and then it had that.
That was the slogan.
Yes. Ball tipped around and active on the glass are the Colonels, but that time they committed a foul in the process. So Elvis now with 3.
Got to be a man down there. Go up there with 2 hands, grab the rebound, body's flying, elbowing.
Now it's just your practices.
That's why you got to reward those big fellas. Like right now, good job, big fella. Throw it in there to him. Let him get an easy one. There he is. There he is.
Pick. Ball knocked away. Good active hands. The hands in the passing lanes from Nicholls State, even the times when they're not getting turnovers, the deflections to interrupt the play. You could tell that Launch knows what he's doing. He may be 29. He knows what he's doing on that. On that sideline.
Sure.
Down low and a ball turned over by the Panthers. Jones gets it down low. McCallahan misses at Bonnie and the ball tipped out of bounds off of Pitt will be Nicholls basketball. You see, Jeff Capel trying to get his team to calm down.
That's one thing.
When you're a young team, it's so much of a psychological game as much as X's and O's.
And effort. You just brought up deflections. That's a stat that they keep in practice.
And a deep 3 from D'Angelo Hunter. Now 3 of 4 from beyond the arc. Nicholls State 10 of 19 from 3. Johnson, nice move to finish.
Nice finish with the left.
Johnson just was 6. The Panthers trail by 6.
The intensity. Who's going to set the tone for the Panthers here on defense when you need to stop?
And a carry by Jones. So a turnover by Nicholls State. D'Angelo Hunter. A red-hot Nicholls State team still from 3, shooting 50% and a 6-point lead in NC State. And another team that's going to show no quit, have a lot of resolve, play hard. Robert Morris opens their brand new building, hosting the Panthers at 6 o'clock on Tuesday. And you know, Robert Morris is going to come to play. What an opportunity for them to have the Panthers travel to their gym across town. You know, this Boston College team, Austin Clunch was on the staff, or excuse me, this Nicholls State team, when they won at Boston College a couple of years ago. Of course, took Illinois to overtime in the first game as an offensive foul by Xavier Johnson. That's 3 on the Panthers' point guard.
Murphy is telling him to swing it to that corner. You know, with the hand, I can't say that I disagree with him with the hot hand he's had lately. This game, or develop that nice pull-up jump shot. Can't get there all the time, young fella.
And Johnson checks out of the game. And I was a foul short. That's 4 on Johnson. Floater and rebound. Murphy goes in to take control. Murphy's got Hunter shadowing him for a minute. Drumgoole kicks it. Murphy thought it. Steps back, 3, no good. Rebound tipped by Brown and controlled by Terrell Brown. Drumgoole drives the lane but forgot the basketball.
It's not a good flow offensively, but it's early still. Early in the season, I mean.
And foul on McGowan's. That's number 2 on number 2. 3rd for the Panthers here in the second half. A week from Sunday, that man, Austin Clunch, turns 30. His team Something trying to give him an early present.
Yeah. How huge would that be to get a road win against an ACC opponent?
He also, in his second year, like Jeff Capel, trying to build a program. And this would be a signature win, no doubt. Clock running down. Deep 3, no good. Rebound Tony, and Tony's come alive on the boards. That's number 7 for Audis Tony. McGowan's reads it, drives it, scores it.
Full control of his body. Getting a shot off. There's the extended pressure.
And the lead now 4. How will Nicholls handle being the hunted here for the last 10 minutes?
They play Illinois tough. You wonder if it's creeping into their mind. Here we go again.
Foul on Tony, his first.
Just a tough shot, getting to the basket, using your body, avoiding the block shot, taking the contact. And that guy's only a sophomore there. Still a lot to learn. Still a lot to develop in his game.
Champagne back in for the Panthers. Harvey for the Colonels. A lot of contact, nothing called. 3 off the glass from the side, no good. Here comes McGowan's. Panthers down 4. McGowan stops from 3, no good. Drops, no foul called. Bodies down. Everybody up and going. Here comes Johnson the other way. Thibodeau native, looking for a moment, and a 3, and a, excuse me, a 2, foot on the line for D'Angelo Hunter, and a timeout for the Colonels. Nicholls State won't go away, up 50.
The Panthers, the way he's coming out here and playing.
And a little 2-3 zone here from Nicholls State. Panthers get a wide open 3, look no good. Rebound, Terrell Brown. And Murphy has to fight, ball tipped, and it's going to be a foul on Kevin Johnson. That's 3 now on Johnson.
Johnson doesn't like that call. I feel like it was a loose ball. It's close. Position.
6-point lead for the Colonels. Picked 11th in the Southland Conference. Ryan Murphy, essentially a point guard now with Johnson and Xavier Johnson in foul trouble. Brown, fake, scores.
Call for it, big fella. Demand it.
You know, there are times where Terrell Brown like becomes a whole different player and can not take over a game, but can be a big part of what you're doing.
Whether it's a block shot, a big rebound, an and one.
Saw that against Florida State. Good defense from the Panthers. Kick out controlled nicely by Buford. Five on the clock. Spin. Doesn't hit rim. And ball blocked by Brown. Would have been a shot clock violation. That's what they're calling, which stopped the Panther break. Mizzou starting to become, starting to get alive here.
Look at the poise. Yeah, I mean, just the poise to wait for the double team to leave. Hands up. I'm bigger than you. I'm just going to wait for you to go up and send it back to you.
All ball. That's why he's top 10 in Panther history at blocked shots. Runner from Murphy off board, no good. And rebound to Kevin Johnson.
Still a lot of basketball to be played. No need to force the issue.
And there's a force right there. Gowans comes the other way. Alley-oop to Tony. Ball tip. And we'll tell you whose basketball it is. It's 57. Old though.
For you guys that like to wear the jacket and the tie, you know, and all, I gotta just, you know, give you a little
flow. You're from Buffalo. You should be warm enough.
This guy, Ronald Ramon, is easily one of the top three shooters in Pitt history. Easily.
So how does he go from the booth to a coaching job?
I don't know. He said I was good. Afterwards, he said, bro, you're kind of really good at this TV thing. And I said, yeah, I mean, I'm just being myself here. He felt like he couldn't compete with his big bro. He has the personality and the patience to be on over there. I don't have it.
He could do either.
Absolutely.
We enjoyed our time with Ronald.
Great guy.
McClanahan, just 2 points, and he'll go to the line. And, you know, we would have thought Julius, if you would have said, okay, McClanahan has 2 points, 7:37 to go, I would have thought Nicholls would be down 30.
Easily. But sharing a basket, I mean, this is great for their program to get the job done without their leading scorer coming out here and having a huge game. Only make you a little more difficult for the next opponent to prepare for you.
Lanahan, 1,000-point scorer in 3 years at Savannah State. We told you about the mask. You know, he wore the mask in the first half against Illinois, had 5 points. Went into halftime, got rid of the mask, had 20. Now, he's only had 3 points here, but you mentioned it. 5 assists, 5 rebounds. Good defense.
Yeah, there's other ways to have an influence on the game than just scoring the basketball. And good for him to have confidence in these guys, and a big, huge good for his teammates for being able to rise to the occasion.
What do you think about Murphy at point here?
Well, I mean, based on personnel.
And the 4 fouls with Xavier Johnson. Gowans drives, kicks. Little Murphy in there. He kicks it out.
A chance to get McGowan's free.
Panthers need to shoot it. Shot clock expired. Solid defense from Nicholls State. Maybe we haven't said that enough. The foul trouble for Xavier Johnson, obviously playing a factor. He's only been able to play 19 minutes. He's a guy that played 35 easy in a game.
Yeah, he averaged 15 points last year, so we've been talking about the troubles of Nicholls State leading scorer. You know, the Panthers leading scorer also hasn't been able to get a rhythm in this game due to foul trouble. It's something that he's going to have to learn how to overcome as he goes to the table to check in.
Letiche, that's not where he can do his best work, as the Panthers doing a nice job here defensively. And a steal by McGowans. McGowans against McClanahan. Panthers within 3.
Effortless hops. Effortless hops. Let's see if that's the play that gets him going, Jeff.
3-point game. Nicholls State without a field goal for 3.5 minutes.
And a near turnover there. Champagne, and Murphy gets it. Murphy drives. Lefty shot. He's fouled. And he'll shoot the foul on Johnson, and that's his fourth.
Murphy getting it done.
You see McGowan's.
McGowan's take off. He's a one-foot jumper, too. That's flight right there. That's taking flight. That's not close to the basket. He's an explosive guy.
Ryan Murphy with 19 points, 4 rebounds, 3 assists.
Defensively complete.
And, oh, by the way, at 9:30 last night, Murphy's out shooting. He told us after the game that he'll come in every night and he'll leave after he's made 700 shots.
That's going to get it done. You know, I hear some crazy stories about guys that can shoot the ball. You know, Chris Mullin shooting after actual games and things like that. If you want to be one of those guys, you got to put the work in.
He's doing that. Missed a couple of free throws there, though, and the lead still three for Nicholls. Ooh, a near turnover. But a crossover by Hunter, and he finishes.
He wants to get to that pull-up. You got to know by now, you got to take that away.
That's 17 for Hunter, leading scorer for the Colonels. 4:45 to go. A 5-point lead. McGowan stuck in the lane. Tony, ball knocked away. McGowan's three, short. And Murphy was in there trying to get a rebound, and he tied up the big man. Zalatiche.
Murphy understands. He understands what's going on, trying to get it done.
You know, especially for a transfer to walk in and have this type of energy and be. And here's Xavier Johnson, and you may have to kind of situation him in this game with the four fouls. We'll use him in spots. We'll see what Jeff Capel does. 150-8. You see that. The Panthers have only lost twice in their history in November. Murphy!
There he is. 150-8. It's impressive.
21 points for Ryan Murphy. The Panthers within a possession.
Need a big stop here.
Well, oh, Murphy.
There it is. Murphy
loose. Here comes
basketball.
Johnson. Johnson stepping, scoring. Panthers down one. The crowd coming to life. The team was the only one sleeping early. The crowd was as well, but you get a couple of steals, you get some fast breaks, you get a dunk as Xavier Johnson comes back in the game, and the Panthers now trail by just one.
30 girls for me in timeout.
Get you going, a little more pep in your step. Guys on the bench look like they're having a good time also. Let's see if it translates to another defensive stop.
Speaking of defense, Panthers have held Nicholls State to 29% shooting here in the second half. Panthers now trail by one. It has been all Nicholls all day. No lead. Since 1-0 for the Panthers.
Have to contain the penetration.
Smith blocked by Brown. Shot off and in.
How exciting is that?
I don't know how that rolled in.
Every piece of the rim right there.
And a good trap here by Nicholls State. No one does help. Here comes Nicholls. Good look and a foul. Champagne had to foul. Or it'd have been an easy two. Now watch, how does this go in?
Getting the hand on the ball, keep it alive. If you can't grab the rebound.
Was there a little help? Watch right here.
No.
Anthony lived up here for a moment.
That's why it's a circle. Andre Jones makes the first free throw. 4-point lead. Jones with the dozen. And credit to Nicholls. Building was hopping. Get a turnover. Couple good rolls for Nicholls, although you know what, they've earned their rolls.
Absolutely.
In this game.
Absolutely. When you play tough, you play hard, you dive on the floor, attack the glass, good things seem to happen for you.
Panthers down 5-3 to play. And a turnover by Pitt. Low pass to Murphy, couldn't handle. And a sloppy, careless mistake from the Panthers.
The Panthers have to figure out a way to get Brown the ball when he has a mismatch down there. And not only that, do I want them to look into him, but he has to open up his mouth. He's going to have to call for the ball.
18 turnovers for Pitt and a deep throw-in. Pretty good football pass there from D'Angelo Hunter. Kevin Johnson. You've said this from the beginning, but the motion, you don't see Nicholls, although you see it here a little bit, standing still. They've done a nice job with their offense. And Johnson drives, ball knocked out of bounds, 7 to shoot.
Make something happen. Penetrate the pass.
Kevin Johnson driving right at us. And some contact, no call. 5-point lead for the Colonels. Again, 7 to shoot. Inbounds. 3. Dagger. Johnson with 14. And the lead is 8.
Nicholls is doing a good job at full front in the post against Brown. Might need a little high-low action.
You feel some impatience there as McGowan's was just dribbling out and airballs the layup. McGowan's gets the rebound, kicks it. Murphy tries to create a shot, has it knocked away. Tries to maybe overpass to Champagne there, and a turnover and a jump ball. D'Stoney and McClanahan.
I like the scuffles.
Man,
that's just out of bounds. You can't have that.
The Thibodeau native. And you see McGowan's just missed the layup and the tip.
A little bit of balance also. Sometimes it just be that way. It's not your day.
And Nicholls is 156 away from a pretty big upset here. Their head coach looking for that signature win, much like Pitt against Florida State last year, or the Notre Dame win, or the Louisville win. Nicholls,
starts
6 transfers this year. The T-Shay's wide open, and he misses. Audis Tony with rebound number 9. Murphy stops, pops, drops. And a timeout for the Panthers, down by 5.
It's not over yet, still a long game.
How about Murphy?
Nicholls State.
But you got to find ways. I mean, you think that's happening, and then the Panthers screw something up. Ryan Murphy.
He's been a guy.
Wednesday, Murphy.
Well, that was something that the Panthers needed badly this season. They had the penetration down last year, but didn't have a guy outside of Wilson Frame last year that could knock down that three. But they found their guy, I would say.
So what do you call that thing with arrows? Is that called a quiver, I think, where you put arrows in?
Arrow?
Seriously.
Is it?
So we got to find how many more arrows does he have in that quiver? And here's the one he just nailed.
If he's making 700 jump shots a day, I think he has an unlimited.
Now,
He didn't say jump shots. He said shots.
Okay.
But I'm going to guess he's probably not doing a lot of empty layups.
No, not at all. We should have that down by now at this point.
Inbound and a travel. A turnover on Nicholls State against Elvis Harvey. So the Panthers have it down five, 1:25 to go. One, two, three. I don't know, would you consider that a jump?
I always complain about the referees, but I'm just as bad. So I don't critique a little too much.
If you had to write apology letters, there'd be a lot of referees that would be glad to hear from you, Julius.
If I was the referee, you might as well not even give me a whistle, because I'm not calling anything.
And some confusion here for the Panthers. I don't know what we're I guess they want to move them up a little bit more. So the Panthers, Audis Tony will inbound with D'Angelo Buford on him. Xavier Johnson. Johnson, cross court. Champagne drives and blocked a bit at the hoop. Offensive rebound from Terrell Brown and a three-point opportunity.
Similar to what happened against Florida State. And one bucket by Brown.
Eight for Brown and a chance to get the Panthers within two.
Nice strong penetration.
And Champagne didn't have it blocked. He just got in a little too deep. And Terrell Brown is there.
Way to stay active around the rim. The effort pays off.
Brown's first trip to the free throw line. And no good. Ball tipped and controlled by Nicholls State. Well, we get a look at this, and I think we will go to replay, which gives both teams a chance to discuss here.
Oh.
Did Nicholls get it there at the end?
I don't know. It looked like Xavier Johnson touched it last to me.
Yeah, I don't think Andre Jones got his hand on it. See what the officials see.
And since he caught it in Nicholls State favor, I'm not sure if it's enough.
All right, here we go again. See X going after. It's definitely off his hand there. It's a matter of, did the Nicholls State player get it after that? Zoom in.
Is that just his hand behind the ball, or is he actually touching it?
I don't think he got it. I don't think that swipe touched the basketball. What do you think, Julius?
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't think.
Well,
and it will be Nicholls basketball.
It was close enough for him to actually gain control of it.
And I think we get to a point in replay, as much as you want to get the call right, when you start delaying games minutes, you're doing more harm to the game than good.
Absolutely. I agree with you. Standing around is not a good thing for either team. Yeah.
So the Panthers down three, plenty of time. A minute 14 on the clock. See, the Panthers have one timeout. Nicholls has one timeout. And the inbound, Kevin Johnson. Johnson's going to drive, but stay out, and a foul on the Panthers. And if that's on, it's not on Johnson, it's on Champagne.
This was just tricky for Nicholls State. A lot of times in this position, you play the game not to lose it. Instead of being aggressive, playing to win, you try to hang on to what you have and end up losing.
So there, would you drive the lane instead of doing what Johnson would have done?
I'm not saying that I would just drive the lane. I mean, the time is on your side. I'm just saying you can't. There is a such thing as being a little too conservative and not just making a basketball play and relying on your defense to get a stop.
Nicholls now 7 of 10 from the foul line.
You know, you could pass up on an easy layup, get fouled, go to the line and miss it, become a free throw shooting contest, and it can actually backfire.
It's back to a two-possession game. And calmly, Kevin Johnson goes to the line, the junior. Drills a couple of free throws, and now Xavier Johnson tries to get something going for the Panthers. Behind the back, sweet. Drive, scores. Now a three-point game.
He makes that look so easy.
And we have a turnover here. We have a hook. So an offensive foul called on the Colonels.
Oh, yeah. It's an easy call. He didn't even hit him with the chicken wing and try to get away with it with just the elbow.
Got a timeout on the floor. The officials are going to the front. I don't know what could we discuss here. Or are we just...
Always going north and south, behind the back. Adjust the ball.
Here's why we had the delay. That's the fifth foul on Kevin Johnson.
Is it?
So Johnson fouls out.
It's a tough way to foul out of the game on offensive foul.
16 points. And if this game were somehow to get to overtime, Kevin Johnson, obviously a big part of what Nicholls does. Drive by Murphy, drops. Boy, we've seen more kind rolls here than in your 4 years with the Panthers. Panthers,
that's because we didn't see
pressure.
Any
McClanahan, he's going to attack against Terrell Brown and scores. Clutch play by the senior. 61-58. Panthers' best free throw shooter is right there, and Murphy is fouled by McClanahan.
What do you do here, Jeff?
I'm not panicking for a three. And what a play here by McClanahan. Almost lost it.
Almost lost it, able to go up over one
of the best shot blockers in Pitt history. I'm telling you, if Nicholls wins this, they earned it.
Yeah.
You know, there are times where teams give you a game. Nicholls will have earned this win as Murphy makes the first free throw. And then says something to the official.
It's a lot of yapping going on. It's a close game. Nicholls State in the Panthers' ear, as they should be.
Murphy hits two. The transfer out of New Mexico Junior College, before that, Charlotte. The junior from California puts the Panthers down one. Defense there, and a foul by Champagne. That's four on the freshman. Now Xavier Johnson comes in. McGowan's goes out. Murphy with a career-high 28 points for the Panthers. And I'll turn the question on you. What are you doing here offensively as Alda Tiche goes to the line?
I think it depends if he makes both of these, which it looks like he's going to do. I like to extend the game still, get to the basket, maybe foul again.
So not necessarily going for a three, just the fastest bucket you can get?
Absolutely.
Okay. Nobody on the foul line. Second free throw, clutch. Nicholls State has been pretty much clutch at the line. Xavier Johnson, Panthers down three. Looking, Champagne kicks to the corner. Driving is Tony, and Tony walks. So an inbound now for the Colonels. 18.4 to play. And they get the inbound to Jones. Jones drives. Johnson doesn't want to foul him. He's got four. And the foul on Tony, who now has two. Excuse me. No, they call that on Johnson. So Johnson is fouled out.
Well, Brown isn't picking up this guy on the press. So.
Yep. Yeah, obviously on Johnson. He held off for a couple of seconds and then realized time's not on our side.
I need a little help at the line.
And they get it. You might want a three. Oh, Murphy and turns it over. And spin move, no good, but dropping in, and Nicholls State is going to win here at Pitt. Champagne tries a three. It wouldn't have mattered anyhow. Nicholls State storms the court as they win here at Pitt. Wow, Julius.
Well, they came in, they played tough, they made shots, they penetrated the ball.
Yeah, and, you know, the Panthers trying to get something going. Still not, you know, you don't have Xavier Johnson to be able to bring the ball up the court.
That's why it was tough to lose him to that foul. Murphy, more of a shooter than he is, somebody that can break that. But you got to give credit to Nicholls State, applying that pressure, not backing up and panicking.
And what was it about Nicholls? Why did they win this game?
I think they just came out and played with a lot of heart, played with a lot of fire, and didn't back down from the beginning.
They
made
were
some shots, penetrated the basketball.
They're a confident team as Nicholls State, for the first time since 2016 with a win at Boston College, they come north against a Power 5 school and get a victory, 75-70. So for Julius Page and our outstanding crew, I'm Jeff Hathorn saying so long from Pittsburgh, where the final score is Nicholls State 75 and the Panthers 70. To watch this entire game on replay, as well as other games on the ACC Network, download the ESPN app. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader.